Hi guys, Greg here, and welcome back to SITENG, where you will find all interesting stuff about life and work of a civil engineer. And in today's video, guys, I'm going to show you the BLUEBEAM here again, and we're going to be starting doing the markups, which is a very important thing for us engineers, as we want to keep the information flowing in the nice manner, really. And while we keep the information on site, we're using the markers and the markups. This is very good. But to keep information in a professional way, and especially where we're dealing with a client and with a designer and all these guys, really, we want to do it, in, as I said, in a professional way. So let's have a look how to do these markups and how actually BLUEBEAM making our life easy. So guys, as you can see on the last video here, once we're going to jump in tools, we got the markup here, and we're going to be taking whatever we need really from here. But what I want to mainly show you in today's video, we're going to create a few tools and we're going to put them in our toolbox. You can see here now there is a tool chest and going to be my tools, and we're going to be creating some tools when we're going to be used. So the most important thing, the most used thing, guys, is actually I'm using the rectangle. So I'm going to put R for it. And as you remember, this is sketching here. So let's see, we're going to put it for now, rectangle like this. And once we created it, we got the options here, so we can change the line. If you want to change the color of the line, we want to pick from here. I'm going to go for black. If you want to take thickness of the line, we can go from maybe, for instance, here 3 points. You can see the line, and I always fill it here with a yellow color. But what I want to do, I want to highlight. That's the most used option here, and in terms of markup, I think that's the most used really option. So I'm going to go, guys, here to the settings on the left hand side. I'm going to press it here, and I got everything here, so I can actually change it from here as well. But what I want to press here, I want to press highlight, and as you can see here, this is highlighted now with my black border here around with 3 points here. And we can obviously do some scaling, some other stuff, but it doesn't matter. Once we create it here, we can right click it here and we can add to my tools here from here. So we get my tools. We can also, once we got it here, we can also add it from here. We can press here. You got it, add to tool chest as well. So that's the same. So I can add it actually, we're gonna have probably two. So number one, number two. So guys, the great thing about my tools, and that's the most used by me really, it's wherever I'm gonna press number one here, I'm gonna have a rectangle with my settings here. So you can see the border is the same, it's a yellow highlight, so I don't need to press all that stuff again. But the most important thing, and that's what I like the most here, I'm gonna go back here to my tools and I'm gonna double click it here. And as you can see, that small icon change a bit. And what that means now, wherever I'm going to press number one, and I'm going to take my tool here, I'm going to be one, and I'm going to be creating whatever rectangle I want with my settings. That's absolutely fantastic. I love it. And then we're going to be obviously setting some other tools as well. Whatever you're going to be using, if it's going to be arrows, if it's going to be lines, whatever settings you're going to put, and put it then to your tools, and then you're going to be using just by clicking 1, 2, 3. So imagine how that speeds up all the process whenever you're going to be dealing with the drawings and you want to show something. So what I'm going to do, guys, now, maybe I'm going to I just delete this one, I don't need it really. And I'm going to go maybe here, I'm going to show you, I'm going to use a polygon here just to show you how easy it is. If you got some strange shape, you maybe remember from my last video, I got a snap here. So that's another great thing about the BLUEBEAM here. So let's say we got not the typical shape, let's go, we got some strange pour or whatever, and I'm gonna go here, and in this case I can actually press C, it's gonna close the polygon, and I can go and do the same story here. We can fill it maybe this time with the green one. I go maybe here, settings, highlight, and I can add it. Actually, I'm gonna go from here, I'm gonna add it to our tool chest. So my tools, and that's number two. And what I'm gonna do, I just double click it as well, I don't want the same option here. So wherever I'm gonna press now, number two, you're gonna go for polygon, and I can do wherever I like, C, and that's what I got. So this is great, guys. I think I don't have to say too much about it. You can see yourself how easy marking up is now. And what I have to tell you, obviously on site, you're gonna be still using, sometimes you're gonna have drawings on the wall, you're gonna be physically marking them with the highlights, which is also good. But guys, imagine this, this is the 21st century. So once you want to send the information to someone, you want to show something in a nice way, guys, please do it this way. Sometimes if I see some scans and all this stuff, this all looks like from 1990s. So forget about the old days, guys, and start working this way, showing the information proper way, so it's clear and everyone sees what it is. So guys, what I'm going to set maybe as well here, I'm going to go here, you can see tools, we got all abbreviations here. So I'm going to do T for text and A for arrow. So I'm going to use A here for arrow, let's say like that, and I'm going to change this arrow. I want it a little bit bigger here, and I maybe keep it the red color. I'm happy with that. And what I'm gonna do now, again, I'm gonna add it as my number 3, should be there, my tools. Yeah, I got that arrow now. So wherever I'm gonna press number 3 here, I'm gonna have my arrow wherever I want. I'm gonna mark it here. So great thing, guys. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go for T for text. And I'm gonna write something here. Okay, that sounds good. And I'm gonna change it as well. As in terms of writing, I wanna actually black color here. And I'm gonna go back here with it, so we can see here. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna go actually fill white. So everyone's gonna see this information here. And I'm gonna change the font weight as well. Let's say 26. Yeah, that sounds nice. I'm gonna extend it a little bit, so you can always work this way. Extend that box. I'm gonna go back here. I just changed the border for black, so you can see here, you got font here, so you can change actually the font itself. You got font weight, and the color of the font is here, so I'm gonna change it for black here. I added as well to my toolbox as number 4 in this case, so I'm gonna add to tool chest, my tools, and that's number 4. But I delete it for now, and just maybe we're gonna do just a quick exercise. Let's say we're gonna mark up quickly. We pulled something from grid line A14 to A17, so how quickly it is, guys. Look, just press number 1, bank. This is the markup here. What we got here, number 4 now, and that's the pour. Number 1 and date, whatever it is, let's say that's gonna be 24/12. So we are pouring at the Christmas Eve. So that's, guys, how easy it is. You got all markup, you got pour. Obviously, when you're marking your pours, you probably put how many cubic meters you pour. Why we're here, guys, and we're talking about the writing, maybe how we can check it, you can actually mark it here. You can go to the style and you can just not line, but you can just press here, and that's it. And that's cubic meters, so that's great as well. Just quickly one click there and it looks like it should be looking. We can just maybe go out the box, make it a little bit smaller, and look how lovely it is, guys. So I think that'll be all in today's video, covering the markups. The main thing for today would be the creating my tools. And once you're gonna download your trial version, on once you got your BLUEBEAM ready, that would be the most important thing, guys. This is making your life much, much easier. And then you're not gonna be actually taking from your tools here, markup tools, as you're gonna be using your shortcuts there. So I think that's absolutely fantastic, as I said before, and that makes our life much easier. Wherever you're gonna mark something, you wanna send something to architect, or you wanna be marking whatever work you've done already, like here in this case, that's the great thing, guys. And in the next video, guys, I'm gonna start showing the measures here as well, as this is, I think, actually the best thing in BLUEBEAM. When we're gonna be measuring, we're gonna put the scale into the drawing and we're gonna be working with it, which you're gonna see it's great, because if the drawing is not too scaled even, we can still use it, and that's the best thing, guys.
Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if so, please don't forget to leave the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel as well, and this is helping to reach out to more people and to get them a chance to see how the life and work of a civil engineer looks, guys. So thank you again for watching, and see you next time.